It is our Minnesota state fish, but is the state of our walleye in jeopardy? In tonight's EarthCare, Chris Horapsky looks at why some researchers think certain populations could dramatically drop in the coming years.
We're ready to go when you're ready to go.
We are sitting on one of the best natural reproduction walleye lakes in the country.
It's easy for Matt Traino to relax on Lake Mille Lacs.
You're in my office right now. This is where I go to work on a daily basis.
But as a fishing guide for 18 years, his office has changed.
Change is hard. It always is. So we've had our ups and downs, both with population and sheer volume.
Walleye population has declined on the lake, according to the DNR. And the blame is cast broadly. Invasive zebra mussels have changed the water clarity. Spiny water fleas eat all the baby fish food. Political harvest battles. Big walleyes eating baby walleyes.
Nothing eats more walleyes than walleyes.
Now, a new study suggests the climate is changing faster than the walleye can adapt, creating a potentially dangerous domino effect.
We do see this kind of fundamental ecological problem that's happening.
The study's lead author, UW-Madison researcher Martha Barda, says walleye have encountered a timing problem where spawning and available food are growing out of sync.
Essentially, we're seeing this mismatch between the date of walleye spawning and the date of when the ice melts on the lake. And this is creating some sort of trophic mismatch where we see that the baby walleye are not always around at the time of the peak of their food.
Historically, when the ice on lakes melt, it's one of the cues for walleye to spawn. At the same time, the food chain begins. Microalgae called phytoplankton start to bloom, and microscopic zooplankton eat the algae. And this becomes the all-you-can-eat buffet for baby fish. Barda and her team looked at data from 194 lakes in Wisconsin, Minnesota, and Upper Michigan, finding the changes in spawning dates aren't biologically keeping up with the changes in ice out dates.
By the time the baby walleye hatch, their food resources are essentially gone, and that this is actually associated with lower survival to adulthood of baby walleye.
Mille Lacs was not part of the study, but looking at a graph of ice out dates, you can see the extremes growing wider. This year, setting a record early ice out.
This is going to be hard news for some people to think about. Obviously, this is our Minnesota state fish.
DNR Regional Fisheries Manager Brian Nurbin reminds us that most lakes in the lower two-thirds of the state have walleye because they're stocked. He says if naturally reproducing walleye lakes in the north see declines, those changes could ripple across the state.
Yeah, I don't think we're going to be able to stock our way out of this problem. We're the land of 10,000 lakes. We've got a lot of places where people want to walleye fish. And we may have to make priorities about where we can provide that opportunity for people.
The key, Nurbin says, is to focus on the natural habitats of walleye.
The nice Mille Lacs Lake walleye.
Like Lake Mille Lacs, Leech, Winnebogoshish, and Lake of the Woods. Study what's working or not working in those places.
It would be delicious.
Despite mistrust between some anglers and researchers.
It would be silly for us to ignore the changes going on.
Matt's optimistic. He believes each lake is unique.
That's a walleye right there.
Just like every trip out.
Here comes a fish.
Strategy.
That is a big fish.
And disappointment.
Oh, no.
It's all right.
Are all part of the game.
It was a whale.
On Lake Mille Lacs, Chris Horapsky, Care 11 News.